Good morning. Welcome to ICSE 9th Standard Physics. Today we are doing the topic pressure in fluids, and we are going to learn how to solve the numericals based on pressure in fluids. Basically, when we talk about pressure, remember the formula for pressure. Pressure is thrust upon area, which means the pressure is more if the thrust is more. What is thrust? It is the force that acts normally on a surface. So basically what thrust is the force which acts at perpendicular at a perpendicular direction to the surface, and that upon area. More the area, less will be the pressure, and less the area, more will be the pressure. So we are going to use the formula pressure is going to be thrust upon area. So now our question says a hammer exerts a force of 2.5 newton on each of the two nails, and the nails are having areas of cross section 5 millimeter square and 1.5 millimeter square respectively. Calculate the pressure on each nail. Now when you are given a question like this, the best way to start is to write the data for each nail. So you will have nail number 1 and you will have nail number 2. Now for the nail, area of cross section A1 becomes 5 millimeter square, and for nail 2, area of cross section will be A2, and that is 1.5 millimeter square. Now as you can see, the force has been given in Newton, so the area has to be converted into SI unit. And so if we look at the conversion factor, 1 millimeter is 1/10 of a centimeter. So if we want a millimeter to be converted into a meter, you will divide, because it's area will be, you will divide first by 10 into 10, that is you will divide by 100 to make it into centimeter square, and then centimeter square into meter, you will take 100 into 100. Which means you are actually dividing by 10 to the power 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, that is 10 to the power 6, and that becomes 5 divided by 10 to the power 6 meter square. Now you can also remember it this way, that the prefix milli means 1/1000th of the meter. So if it is 5 millimeter square, you will divide it by 1000 into 1000. So that gives you a conversion factor. Let us come to area 2. With the same logic, we will say 1.5 will be now divided by 10 to the power 6, and that will be a value of the area for nail 2 in meter square. The force on each one is 2.5 newton, as you can spot here, and here also it will be the same, which is 2.5 newton. So you will have P1, which is pressure on the first nail. It will be F1 upon A1, because as I told you, it is thrust upon area, the formula for pressure, and we substitute the values. What are the values? It is, force is 2.5 newton divided by 5 upon 10 to the power 6 meter square. That gives us 25 upon 10, remove the decimal so that it becomes easier for you. And now you are dividing by 5 upon 10 to the power 6. So 5 will go in the denominator, 10 to the power 6 will come in the numerator, and your unit will be Newton per meter square. So 5 ones and 5 fives. So you will see it is 0.5 into 10 to the power 6 Newton per meter square, and as you know, Newton per meter square is also called as Pascal, and that gives us 5 multiplied by 10 to the power 5 Pascal. So this becomes our answer 1. Exactly the same thing you will do for P2. P2 is going to be F2 upon A2. Substitute, F2 is 2.5 newton divided by, it is now 1.5, divided upon, it will be 10 to the power 6. That gives you 25 upon 10 multiplied, here it is meter squared. 25 upon 10 multiplied by 10 to the power 6 upon 15, and the 1.5 becomes 15 in the denominator, 10 in the numerator. 10, 10 get cancelled, and you will have 5 5s and 5 3s. So you will get 5 upon 3 is 3 1s and remain 2. So 3 6 18, so it becomes 1.67 into 10 to the power 6 Newton per meter square, which is also Pascal. So you have your pressure on the second nail, and that becomes your answer 2. So now that we understood how the pressure on the nail can be, let us come to another. A very popular question goes like this. We will have a block of iron. As you can see, the dimensions are given. The dimensions are 10 by 8 by 12 by 8 by 10. And here also the same dimensions. Only thing is that the area in contact with the surface is this. So this area is in contact is going to be 8 multiplied by 10, which is going to be 80 centimeter square. And in this area diagram, you will see that the area, because the other surface is in contact, it is going to be, the area in question here will be, this will be 12, this will be 8, so it will be 12 into 8, which is equal to 96 centimeters squared. Now, the mass is going to remain the same, and the mass is going to act upon the surface, and that becomes the thrust. So you will realize that our thrust in each case is going to be 80 kgf. And since they have not given the value of gravitational acceleration, we can consider our pressure in kgf per centimeter square. Now, in case A, shown in the diagram, kept on the surface, shown in the diagram. Here, the question is A, thrust, and number 2, sorry, B, will be pressure in each case. So you have thrust in each case will be 80 kgf. Reason, it is the same block. Now let us come to pressure. So pressure in case A is going to be equal to P1, and that will be equal to F1 upon A1. Therefore, P1 will be equal to, what is the force? It is the thrust. The thrust is going to be F1 upon A1, and F1 becomes 80 kgf, and the area of cross section in this case is 80 centimeter square, and that gives you 1 kgf per centimeter square. This becomes the pressure in case 1. Let us come to B, answer A. Now in case of B, again you will see that pressure depends upon the area of a contact over there, this one. So pressure in case B is going to be equal to P2, which we will call as F2 upon A2. Therefore, let us substitute. P2 will be equal to your force, which is the thrust, will be the same as 80 kgf as in case 1. But in second case, that is B case, you will see that it is 96 centimeter square, and you will now 8 goes 10 times, 8 goes 12 times, 2 5s and 2 6s. So you will see 5 upon 6, which is equal to 0.6 8s 48 remain 2, 6 3s 18 remain 2, so 8.83 kgf per centimeter square. So you will now notice, as an observation, our earlier area was 80 centimeter square and now it became 96 centimeter square, and as the area in contact here has increased, the pressure has decreased. So area controls pressure, lesser the area, more will be the pressure. Now we come to the third question, where we are having a case. The vessel is having the area of cross section. So the area of cross section has been given as 600 centimeter square. When you're reading the questions, you have to identify which data has been given. And if possible, with a pencil, you can just circle it or mark it. It becomes a good tip for you to solve the question. So it contains a water up to a height of 12 meter. Now they say find the pressure. Now out here, you will see that area of cross section has been given and the height has been given. Now pressure, when height is given, we use the formula pressure is equal to h rho g. In the theory part, we have already understood how to derive this. So pressure in a fluid is the height of the liquid column multiplied by rho, which is the density of the liquid column, and g becomes the gravitational acceleration at that place. So as we continue finding the pressure, we have written the formula for pressure in a liquid is h, that is the height, rho, that is the density, and g is the gravitational acceleration. Now here the height is given as 1.2 meter. So we can substitute as 12 upon 10 meter multiplied by rho becomes the density of water. Density of water has been given as 1000 kg per meter cube, and multiplied by gravitational acceleration is 9.8, which is 98 upon 10 meter per second square. And now we can cancel the zeros and we will multiply. So 12 8's 96, carry 9, 12 9's 108 108 and 9 is 117. So 11760, and this is in pascals. So you have the pressure calculated, and that is your answer 1. Now we come to the second part, and in the second part they are asking thrust. Now thrust is to be found out, so you have to link it with what we already know. We know the pressure, which is 11760 pascal, and also we know the area. Now we know that pressure is equal to thrust, that is force upon area, and therefore the force becomes pressure into area. And so we use that formula and we'll say thrust is equal to pressure multiplied by area of cross section. I'll simply put it as CS. Now the pressure is 11760 pascals multiplied by area of cross section is 600 centimeter square. Now this is 600, but it is in centimeter square, and here this is in SI. So obviously this centimeter square will have to be converted into meter square. So you have to divide by 100 times 100, and that will be, this is your pascal, this is going to be your meter square. Now why do we divide by 100 into 100? Because we have 1 meter equal to 100 centimeters. So when centimeters into meters, when we convert, the length will be divided by 100, but when it is area, it will be divided by 100 times 100, and we will have 6 6 36, carry 3, 6 7 42, 45, carry 4, 6 1 6 6 1 6 and 1 7. So that gives us 705.6, and that becomes your Newton, and that is our answer 2. Answer 2, yes. it is answer to. Okay, so in this video we have seen the basic numericals of pressure and fluid. In part 2 we will be doing another type of numericals, which will be based on pressure in fluid and different fluids with different pressures exerted by their columns. So I hope you have understood this. Thank you for watching.